the building, and I'm back with another video. If you're new to my channel, tap that subscribe button so that you won't miss out on any of my new uploads. And if you have already subscribed, what's good, what's poppin', welcome back to my channel. The hair in today's video was sent to me by a company called SVT Hair, and this is a second review that I am doing for them, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick unboxing for you guys. In the packaging, I did receive a set of makeup brushes, a headband, a wig cap, and a pair of lashes. The wig that I will be installing for you today is a 26-inch 13x4 Malaysian body wave wig. This wig is also 180% density. It does have 4 combs on the inside of the wig. The body wave texture is absolutely gorgeous and super well defined. And this wig also has adjustable straps. Before I go ahead and apply the wig to my head, I am going to go ahead and show you guys a quick tutorial on how I pluck the front of my wigs. And the first thing that I like to do is saturate the entire front section of the wig with water and then brush through the hair to make sure there's no sags or anything throughout the hair. Then I'm going to go ahead and part a very thin section of the hair in the middle section of the wig. Now, I like to work section by section. It just ends up being a whole lot easier for me. So I'm gonna start in the top middle section of the wig. Now, when I am plucking, I like to make sure that the hair is as wet as possible, just so it makes it easier to see what you are doing. You can go ahead and dry pluck if that's what you like, but I like to pluck my wigs when they're wet. So now I'm gonna go ahead and take my tweezer and I'm just gonna work it from side to side along this section of hair. Now, I'm not going to concentrate too much in one spot because I do not want to take out too much hair. And as you guys can see, only a little bit of hair came out of that first section. Now I'm going to go ahead and part away another section and begin plucking from left to right, right to left, until I get the desired density that I want in this section of hair. Like I mentioned before, you do not want to pluck too much in the same area because you will thin out your lace too much. You want to do as much as you feel you need to do. And just remember to make sure that each section is well saturated with water so that you can see exactly what it will look like when it's finished being plucked. Now, I am parting straight lines in the front section. I wouldn't focus too much on whether the lines are straight or whatnot. It does not matter. You just want to make sure that you're parting a even section across the front, and then you're gonna go in and pluck each section. Now, I don't like to pluck too much because I like my hairline to be more on the fuller side because my natural hairline is not. So for my wigs, I don't pluck too much, I pluck just enough. And as you guys can see, there is a big difference. Now, for the side sections, I am only going to part away one section because I don't want to lose that density in the side section of my wig. Like I previously stated, my natural hairline is very thin, so when I wear my wigs, I don't like my wigs to match my natural hairline. I like them to be a little bit more fuller, but I still want them to look as natural as possible. Now, to prep my hair, I am going to go in with the Got To Be Glued Ultra Glued Styling Gel, and I'm going to use this to lay my edges down as flat as possible, and then I'm going to go in and do my ball cap method. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just concentrating this product only on my edges, and that's it. I'm not bringing it too far back. Now I'm going to go in with my small edge brush and I'm just going to use this to smooth my edges going back and to lay them as flat as possible so that they won't get in the way when I'm installing my ball cap and my wig. because I do have an extremely low hairline, I am going to be parting away a small section of hair along my temples, and this hair is going to be left out in the front section of my wig. All the other hairs will be going back, and none of that hair will be left out in the front section of my wig. And this just also helps me to better naturally secure the wig onto my head. Now I'm gonna go in with my blow dryer and dry that gel on the front section of my head, and I'm using my hands in a backwards motion to make sure that my edges are laying nice and flat. Now I'm going to go ahead and begin my ball cap method. So I am going ahead and installing this brown wig cap onto my head, and I am cutting holes in the cap by my ears so that I can let my ears out and so that it's not squeezing me. So I am going to go ahead and do that on both sides. Now once I got the cap sitting how I want it, I am going to go in with this Got to Be Glued High Insta-Hold Hairspray, and I'm going to spray this along the entire front section of my head, and I'm going to avoid spraying it on top of the hairs that I left out in the front section of my head. But I'm going to spray a good amount of this because this is what's going to help my cap to stay down. And the reason why I am using hairspray instead of the holding gel is because the hairspray dries a whole lot faster. So I use the gel on my hair to slick my edges back, and I use the hairspray on the cap because it dries a whole lot faster. Now that my wig cap is completely dry, I am going to go ahead and cut away the excess cap along the front section of my head, and I'm going to be very, very careful not to cut any of my hair off in the front of my head. Now, when you guys are cutting the cap off, you want to make sure that you get as close as possible to where the cap stops from the hairspray, because you don't want any extra cap hanging up. Now, I am going to go ahead and show you guys how I cut the cap off on one side, and I'm going to do the other side off camera because it was getting a little difficult to cut in front of the camera. This is what I'm looking like after I went ahead and cut off the excess cap in the front section of my head. Now I'm going to go ahead and use some of my foundation on the cap, and this will help camouflage the lace into your skin so much more. And I love to use a good amount because I want everything to look nice and seamless in the front section of my head. Now I'm going to go ahead and use the same exact foundation color to tint the lace on the wig. And as you guys can see, that lace is pretty white, and that would have not blended in with my skin very well. So I am going to use the foundation on the lace as well. Now I'm going to go in with my High Insta Hold hairspray to set that in place. Now as you guys can see, that lace matches me so much better. Now I'm going to go ahead and apply the wig to my head and position it exactly where I want it to be. And as you guys can see, this wig blends into my skin so good. So now you guys see the importance of applying your skin tone makeup to the cap and to the lace on the wig, because everything blends so seamlessly. Now it's time to install this wig. So for me, I like to part off a thin section of the wig in the front. Then I'm going to go ahead and spray my Got to Be Glued Insta Hold hairspray in the front section on top of the lace in the front. Then I'm going to go in with my blow dryer and just blow dry this section until it's completely dry. Go ahead and do the the same thing for the side section. I'm gonna go ahead and part away a thin section of the hair in the front, comb the hair back, pin it away so that none of the excess hair is in the way. Then I'm gonna go in with my Gatsby Glued High Insta Hold hairspray, and I'm going to spray that along that entire side section, and I'm going to be pretty generous when I'm spraying it. Then I'm gonna comb the hair back to smooth it down. Then I'm gonna go in with my blow dryer to blow dry this entire side section until it is completely dry. Now for my ear tabs, I am gonna go ahead and cut the lace around my ear so that my ear can lay nice and flat around the side section of the wig. Then I'm gonna go ahead and part a section of hair along that side as well. Then I'm gonna pin up the rest of the hair and use my Gatsby Glued High Insta Hold hairspray to tack down that side section of the wig. Then I'm gonna go in with my blow dryer as well to dry this entire section completely dry. I'm gonna go ahead and do the next side off camera, then I'll be back to show you guys how I finish up with styling the wig. Now that I'm done with tacking down the wig, I am gonna go ahead and cut these hairs down in the front section of the wig. Then I'm gonna go ahead and tie the front section of the wig down with a scarf, just so that I can get everything to melt nice and seamlessly into my skin a whole lot better. And I'm gonna go ahead and leave the scarf on for about 10 minutes. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take the scarf down, and now it's time to go ahead and style up these baby hairs. Now for my baby hairs, I am gonna go in with my mini Croc flat iron, and I'm gonna use this to curl my baby hairs. Now I've been seeing this trend of curling the baby hairs on TikTok and Instagram, and I figured I'd try it myself, and I must say I really did like the look. But of course, I did switch it up at the end and went with more of my traditional baby hairs, as you guys will see towards the end of the video. Now I'm gonna go ahead and begin to define my middle part, and I'm just parting away the hair in the front, and I am gonna go in with my Style Factor Edge Booster wax stick, and I'm gonna use this to help define the middle part in the wig along with my hot comb. Now, once I've applied my wax stick on one side, I am gonna go ahead and comb through it with my comb. Then I'm gonna go in with my hot comb to help flatten and smoothen that side section out completely. With this section, you guys want to take your time, do not rush, and please be careful not to burn yourselves when trying to use your hot comb. Now, I like to make my wigs as flat as possible because I feel like I get the most natural look when my hair is nice and laid and flat at the top and side sections of my wigs. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing to the other side. I'm applying my wax stick, then I'm going in with the hot comb to further smooth out the top section and the side section of the wig. Go ahead and go in with my Nairobi foaming mousse, and I am gonna use this to lay my baby hairs in the front because I really wasn't feeling the curls as much as I thought I would have. So I'm gonna use this to lay the baby hairs in the front. Then I'm gonna go ahead and tie the baby hairs down with my edge scarf and leave it to set for a few minutes. Now, you guys can slay your edges however you feel like slaying them. I like to slay my edges this way. Now, I know a lot of people are going to comment and say that my baby hairs are on the thicker side. That was not my intention, and at this point, I did not want to go ahead and pluck them, so I left them as is. But for future references, you guys want to make sure you thin out your baby hairs so that they lay a lot easier and look more natural in the front section of your head. I do have another video coming up showing you guys a better way on how I lay my baby hairs, so stay tuned for that later on this week. Now, while my hair was tied up, I did go ahead and curl some of the back section of the wig while it was tied up, and this is what the wig is looking like, all nice and curled. I am gonna go ahead and touch up the curls in the front section of the wig on camera so that you guys can see exactly how that is done. And I did go ahead and curl the curls away from the face on both sides, and that's what gave me these gorgeous waves. And I really love how the styling of this wig came out. I do want to also mention that I did go ahead and add layers on both sides of the wig in the front, and that's why I am able to get such voluminous curls on the front section of the wig. I did not show me layering the hair in this video because this video would have been extremely long, but if you guys are interested in seeing how I do my layers on my wig, just comment down in the comment section below and I will go ahead and create a video showing you guys exactly how I layer my wigs. After I'm done curling this wig, I am gonna go ahead and run my fingers through the curls to fluff them out. Now, I am gonna go ahead and leave the link to this wig along with any discount codes down in this description box down below so that you guys can go ahead and check this company out. Now, I am gonna go ahead and show you guys my slow-mo so that you guys can see the gorgeous luster, movement, and everything about this wig. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Comment down below any questions that you may have. Like this video and don't forget to subscribe. Bye, my beauties!